I mean, I think the key is to have guys in your minor league system that, you know, they refer to as projectable guys with, you know, high ceilings, toolsy players, that if they figure out how to play the nuances of the game, they become good defenders, have a smart approach to the plate, they turn into star level players. I don't think Kraus profiles as that kind of guy. But when you talk about guys like Soler, Baez, Carlos Correa that the Astros drafted number one, those are the guys you have to hit on. Those are the guys that have to come to the big leagues and not just be, you know, serviceable major league players. They've got to be frontline, big time players.
And if you do hit on, you know, a guy like Kraus who came over from the Diamondbacks organization, well, that's great.
It's twofold. They're scouting. You know, you got to identify the best players, and then the player development people get their hands on them, and they got to polish them up a little bit. You know, the stones, when you get those guys, they're a little rough around the edges. Polish them up. All goes well. You got yourself a pretty good big leaguer. That's, you know, this Dominguez kid, good young player. And the Astros acquired him last year. The story was the glove will play. Glove's good. Whether he hits or not. And kind of streaky, slow start, but really good lately.
To resume, Dominguez talking his way into this at bat after fouling one off his foot.
Get right back in there. Gotta be hardened to play this game every single day. My cop said this is a man's game. It ain't no pink tea. Molly Coddles better stay home. Of course, he was a little over the top.
A lot of sliding spikes high for Ty Cobb.
Speaking of over the top, this is the anniversary. Way back in the day, Babe Ruth made a start. Back when he was pitching, walked the first guy he faced on four pitches, screamed at the umpire after every pitch and after ball four, punched the umpire in the jaw, was ejected. Ernie Shore came into the game, base runner was caught stealing, and then Shore retired the next 26 in a row. One of the great relief appearances in the history of baseball.
I assume Babe got suspended.
Yeah, the game. Let's hope so.
Back then.
Yeah, a little different.
Russell's 1-2 bounced way out in front of the plate.
How the emotions can run high in this sport, in any sport, played at a high level. There's a lot on the line. Seen a lot of heated arguments with umpires. I can't remember the last time I saw somebody take a swing at an umpire. Famous incident where Alomar expectorated on John Hirschbeck.
They later made up and became pretty good friends. A 2-2 count on Dominguez. Russell's offering. Bounced right back to the hill. A crowd today, 35,121, and most of the fans trying to find some shade, as JD mentioned. It's a hot one. Astros were wearing their road grays when we started.
Two or three shirt change for a starting pitcher on a day like today.
Single into center, and they're going to hold Carter. Tremblay at third, deciding down seven. Don't want to get anybody thrown out at the plate.
It's probably the right baseball play. Marwin Gonzalez probably would have appreciated a shot on an RBI, but that's the right call by Dave Trombley. Looks like Dale Swain's got a call of his own here.
On to call to the pen. Carlos Villanueva will spell Russell when we come back to Wrigley.
Toyota can take you far and cost you far less. Toyota Prius is a perfect example. It's been the leader in hybrid technology for the past 13 years, saving drivers money on fuel and keeping them on the road longer with our lasting performance. In fact, 95% of all Toyota Prius sold in the past 10 years are still on the road today. But that's not all.
Get into the Prius family for as low as $199 a month on the Prius C, or get a Prius for just $209 a month. Toyota, let's go places.
Great, you're approved. I'll go get your paperwork.
I'm gonna check your license.
Thanks. We're big fans of the Chicago Blackhawks. Just right there.
Show your loyalty with the BMO Harris Blackhawks Debit MasterCard. BMO Harris Bank, proud sponsor and loyal fan of the Chicago Blackhawks.
It is a Honda call to the pen. It comes with a 12-5 lead here in the eighth inning. Two outs. Runners at first and third. Carlos Villanueva will face Ronnie Cedeno, who won the game for the Astros with a successful sack bunt, pushing across the winning run in the ninth yesterday. Deep breath by the right hander in the pitch. High for ball one.
Starting pitching for the Cubs continues to be very good. Couple of times around the rotation, quality start just about every time out, pitching deep into games, saving the bullpen. Off day tomorrow will really pay off as well, heading into this long road trip. Four teams not doing a lot of winning, but they got a good lineup. Seems to have a fresh ready pen before that series.
Tip strike three. Astros held to a run here in the eighth. They strand two. And we'll head to the bottom of the eighth. The Cubs with a healthy seven-run lead.
Chevy Malibu offers an EPA-estimated 34 MPG highway.
Malibu.
Want safety? It has 10 standard airbags.
Wow, Malibu.
Right now, the deal on one of these is like...
Malibuya?
Malibuya.
Malibuya. Malibuya.
Malibuya.
Visit your local Chevy dealer today. Right now, get this great lease on a 2013 Chevy Malibu LS for around $169 a month.
Great day for a move.
Yeah, you wanna help?
Nah, I'm good.
Hey, I still owe you that $500.
Yeah, and one more. You've got DirecTV.
Yeah.
Call them. They'll hook up your new pad with phone and super fast internet. And you can get that whole home DVR upgrade for free. I just saved you over 500 bucks. It's like you owe me now.
DirecTV Movers Deal. Call now to bundle, plus ask how to get NFL Sunday ticket.
It's our pride in the red, white, and blue. It's our commitment that always comes shining through. It's everything that you need. The hardest working people in America find value at Farm and Fleet.
Sportsnet Central, every night at 6:30, 10, 10:30, and midnight on Comcast Sportsnet, fans' best friend.
Hi, I'm David Kaplan with a Sportsnet Central update. Blackhawks just one win away from their second Stanley Cup in the last 4 years. Join us tonight at 6:30 on Sportsnet Central. Pat Boyle, Steve Conrad, a preview of a potential Game 6 clincher in Beantown. Plus Chris Bowden live from Boston with an update on the status of Jonathan Toews. Now we go back out to the ballpark. Len and the birthday boy, a guy I enjoyed watching when I was a kid, Jim DeShays.
Hey, thanks, Cap. Check out the Audi Legend Suite on the Nuveen Investment Suite level. Watch the game with a former Cubs player. Listen to classic stories about life as a Cub with a luxury food and beverage package and a unique gift for each guest. The Audi Legend Suite is the most exclusive way to watch a Cubs game. For more information, visit Cubs.com/suites.
Left-hander Wesley Wright. The eighth against Nate Scherholz. 2-for-4 with 2 RBIs for Nate.
Longest tenured Astro. Now Wesley Wright's been in an Astro uniform since 2008.
A little shot Cap took at you, wasn't it?
Mm-hmm.
If it was intended that way or not. So what was it like pitching to Hack Wilson?
You know, you had to move the ball in and out on him. You couldn't stay one way with Hack.
Three and one the count. You were how old when you went to your first big league game? Was it Montreal?
Would have been Jerry Park in Montreal. Would have been probably 8 or 9 years of age.
Scherholz with his third hit.
Many chances against Southpaws. Delivers there off Wesley Wright. Cut that one off before Wright could get it to the outside corner. The 69 Expos. Mac Jones. Carl Morton. I don't know if he was there in 69, maybe a year or so later. Of course, the public address guy was bilingual. And when you're a 9-year-old kid, you laugh at a lot of silly things. And the thing that really cracked us up was when he referred to Coco LaBoy as the turd baseman. I mean, as a 9-year-old kid, man, you'd laugh for 2 innings over that one.
Rusty Staub played on that team. Maury Wills.
Mm-hmm.
Dolfo Phillips. Ace was Bill Stoneman, who later would become the GM of the Angels.
Really good pitcher. Steve Renko, maybe?
Yep. With Cat Grant. Oh.
Who managed that club?
That team was managed by Gene Mauch. 52-110 was the record. 69 Montreal Expos. Inside 1-2. Fly out to left. Martinez one hands it.
What a good day for Soriano. A couple extra base hits, triple in the fifth and scored, double in the seventh and scored. Saw the Cubs, as a matter of fact, doubleheader in 69 at Jerry Park.
Remember the time of the year?
I want to say late because I believe that was a doubleheader Cubs Expos followed by exhibition hockey game over at the Forum between the Canadians and the Flyers.
Wow. That is a day. Rizzo's had a good day. Double, sac fly, RBI single, hit by a pitch. He's scored three times. Well, hit deep to right center, and that baby will go. Line shot homer for Rizzo. Give him four RBIs this afternoon.
Left-handed hitters having no problem with the southpaw right. Breaking ball, trying to go down and away. Rizzo out in front and just lifts that thing out of the ballpark. That's our Ford home run replay. So after a long home run drought, Anthony with two this weekend, starting to heat up again. Both off lefties. You got Dallas Keuchel, the opener of this series.
Sweeney already with a career best four knocked in. I can tell you the date of that doubleheader. It was actually in April.
April?
They still would have been playing hockey, right?
Oh, yeah, but they wouldn't be playing exhibition.
Oh, it was an exhibition game? Yeah, the only doubleheader I see Cubs and Expos that year was in April.
Yep.
Fergie Jenkins won the front end of that doubleheader.
Maybe I have my years mixed up. Gone and he knew it.
Two down. Yeah, the problem now with baseball reference is,
yeah,
we can actually find the answer
here. Have all these memories and then you look it up and no, it didn't happen.
Well, they played a lot of doubleheaders back then.
Joe Niekro was on the 69 Cubs. Briefly, moving on to the Padres.
Guess who else was on the 69 Cubs? The uncle of Scott Hairston, John. Pinch hitter, catcher, left fielder. It was the only year he'd play in the big leagues and would only be three games. But he was a member of the 69 Cubs. They took John in the 16th round of the inaugural draft. High fly ball out in the deep right center. Diving attempt by Kraus, can't get it. Castillo to second. Well, the Cubs actually took the Astros batting practice time today. The Astros did not hit on the field. The Cubs did. Maybe the Astros wish they had now.
Raining extra base hits for the Cubs here this afternoon. Castillo joins the hit parade. He had been 0-for-3. Kraus showing a willingness to leave his feet. Last time it cost him an extra 90 feet in the right field corner, turning Soriano's double into a triple. This time no harm. I don't know that he had a legitimate shot at it, but you got to love the young guy selling out. Nine extra base hits for the Cubs this afternoon.
Barney with a runner at second. Two runs in here in the eighth.
Yeah, that's big league dirt. Feels better than AAA dirt. For a boxing match, the Astros might have thrown in the towel by now.
A brief moment where it felt like they were back in the game. That was 5-3 in the fourth. The Cubs have put up a bunch of crooked numbers. Multiple runs in four different frames.
This is where, as a hitter, you don't want to let up at all. I mean, you're going to let up on the bases. You're not going to send runners home and really force the action here in certain situations. But just want to concentrate. Don't give away any at bats. Barney's recent success has just been a much more aggressive approach at the plate. He's not the only one. We've seen it a lot here in recent days from the Cub hitters. Dale talks about hit to take. You don't take to hit. You don't just take pitches just because, to hope you get into a favorable count. You get a pitch to hit early, he wants his guy swinging.
Called strike three, and that'll end the inning. Anthony Rizzo getting into the act on the home run board with number 12, four RBIs on the day. And the Cubs now lead as we go to the ninth, 14-5.
Motor Trend asked people who aren't driving a Ford to take the EcoBoost challenge. Ford Fusion with EcoBoost technology took on Honda and Toyota.
Ooh, baby. Is it a four-cylinder?
37 miles per gallon. That's awesome.
Assisted parking? This is amazing. I feel like I'm cheating on my Honda.
The power, the way it handles, in comparison to the Camry, is a lot better.
It fits my personality. It's me.
It's the final days to get a Fusion for just $279 a month with zero down, zero security deposit, and zero first month's payment.
Find hot deals during the Menards Summer Sale. This 20-foot roll of professional-grade lawn edging from Mastermark is easy to install. Its diamond-shaped bottom keeps edging firmly in place and looking beautiful for years. $3.99. Add beauty and protection to your yard with pre-assembled fence panels. Choose from a great selection of pressure-treated panels. This 6x8-foot dog-eared fence panel is pressure-treated against rot and decay. Now only $36.99.
Save big money at Menards.
There are man-eating sharks in every ocean, but we still swim. Every second, somewhere in the world, lightning strikes. but we still play in the rain because bad things can't stop us from making our lives good.
Tomorrow, Comcast SportsNet brings you around-the-clock coverage of the Stanley Cup Final. Game 6, keep your viewing off at 5 with Sports Talk Live. Then at 6, gear up for the game with Chevy Blackhawks pregame live. And when the final horn sounds, get right back to CSN for Blackhawks postgame live presented by Hawk Ford. Make CSN your Blackhawks headquarters tomorrow for Game 6 of the Stanley Cup Final. Down to the nitty-gritty.
Hard throwing righty, Henry Rodriguez. His numbers combined with Washington and the Cubs.
H-Rod, last time he was out there, we saw him throw a fastball 100 miles an hour.
Two innings in St. Louis. So this is not an indictment of him. It's just the role he has been in this season. This is his 20th appearance combined between the Nationals and Cubs. He has appeared in one of his team's wins. That was on April 4th with the Nationals. So the last 18 times he's been on the mound, his team has lost the game. He's only suffered one of those defeats. So obviously has come into the game trailing much of the time. You saw Bourbon and left. But he's got a chance to pitch in a blowout win here today.
It's not good for your plus minus. Henry with an outstanding arm, a real hard thrower, walks a big part of the problem. And that's why he was not entrusted with leads in Washington this year. He's a good guy for a team like the Cubs, who not a contending team right now, to take a flyer on. Bring him in, take a look at him. See if maybe Chris Bosio can get him to turn the corner.
Sometimes it's just a simple change of scenery. And the mercurial nature of bullpen guys, I mean, tons of examples over the years. Guys who just can't seem to get over the hump, then finally do for whatever reason. Mm-hmm. Guys who have success all of a sudden just have a terrible year and then bounce right back the next year.
Could be mental, confidence thing, or maybe it's mechanical and a different pitching coach has a different suggestion that just seems to click. Henry, 26 years old, from Santa Barbara, Venezuela. Cubs traded an A-ball pitcher for him. Pitched 146 and two-thirds major league innings, struck out 149. That's the good news. The bad news is 98 walks. Difficult to sustain success with that high walk rate.
Let's the leadoff man off the hook. Bring up Jose Altuve. The first walk given up by a Cubs pitcher. The Astros hurlers have only walked two. So tons of offense today, but it's been because of the bats and the defense. A strike called, 0-1. Pedro Hernandez made an emergency start for the Twins in Cleveland today, and they avoid the sweep 5-3 the final. He filled in for Mike Pelfrey, who has a strained back. Pelfrey going to the disabled list. On a bounce, nice play by Rizzo, and can't get the out. Dropped by Castro, everybody's safe. Kind of a tricky hop for Rizzo. He was able to field it cleanly, and the throw appeared to be right on the money. And it'll be the second error of the day on Starlin.
I think Castro reached across to make the catch. He saw Maxwell bearing down on him and was trying to make the play while contemplating how to get out of the way of Maxwell all at the same time. Maybe took his eye off the ball a little bit. Maybe even lost sight of the ball momentarily. I'm not sure, but that's one reason. Just catch it, get out of harm's way. Don't worry about a double play. Perhaps trying to do too much. A little bit of a fielding slump here lately.
Low to Castro, 99 on the gun. Give up bases for outs, even runs for outs here. You're up 9 in the final inning. 2-0. Astro taking all the way, 2-1. Took a little something off it at 90.
Yeah, just to make sure you could get it over. Tiger Woods nice using his 3-wood and hitting it 290 yeah. yards anyway.
Take a little something off and it's 98.
It's just crazy. There's so many good arms in the game. We talk about the strikeout rate and why it's so high, and we talk about hitters' approach, and obviously that's a part of it. But there are so many good arms, and you contemplate the plight of the modern hitter. When you know a lot of times you get a couple at bats against the starting pitcher, then a succession of arms coming out of these bullpens throwing 95 to 98 miles an hour, and one guy better than the next.
Base hit into right. The bases are loaded with no outs, a walk, an error, and now a base hit.
This game will end, and in all likelihood, the Cubs will win. The question is when. Astros just not going down without a fight. Chris Bosio is going to have to make a trip here to the mound. Rondon probably ready to go in the Cubs pen. One of those days where you might describe it as winning ugly because of the miscues, but really when you think about the at-bats and the job the Cubs hitters have done today, it's been an impressive show, and the Astros hitters too for that matter. 29 hits in the ball game total, 19 runs. Early on, some seeing eye hits, but the middle innings on, there's been a lot of solid contact.
J.D. Martinez, bases loaded, no outs, the pitch. Ball one.
Samardzija, when this thing ends, pick up his 5th win against 7 losses. ERA will sit at 3.39. Jeff did not walk anybody today, struck out 5 after he left. It's been Russell, Villanueva, and now H-Rod. All have a little bit of a pre-swing routine. You see J.D. Martinez got that little deal there. Kisses his hand. Idiosyncrasy. A play? Was there a play to be made in the upper deck? Stay with it. Oh no. Man, so sad, but yet fitting in the events right of the day. Did he lose the phone too? Oh, he did save the phone.
He saved the phone, lost the ball. Yeah, well.
Yeah, it's good to keep the phone. That way people can call him and rag on him for dropping the ball.
So they'll talk it over here. 2-2 count. Well, the White Sox lost a wild one in Kansas City, 7-6. They were up 4-0, and then 6-4. The Royals got 3 in the bottom of the 8th to win it. A big error in that game by Alexei Ramirez.
Sox with that loss, 11 games below 500. They're in last place in the American League Central.
Jesse Crane gave up 3 runs. They were all unearned. Ground ball to third. There's one. There's two. Run scores. It's 14-6. But 2 big outs for Rodriguez.
Situations where as an infielder you want to know exactly where you're going with the ball before the pitch. So here I'm going this way, hit my left, so I'll go around the horn. See if they can get Carter out.
Astro the runner at second, 2 outs. Here it is. I think we've seen one of the reasons Rodriguez has had some struggles. You can throw 150 miles an hour, but if you start everybody 2-0, you're putting yourself at a disadvantage. Stuff is definitely there. 3-0.
Good hitters in fastball counts. You don't have that trick secondary pitch. You have to challenge with the fastball, and even if you're throwing 98 miles an hour, most big league hitters, if they're sitting on it, can do something with it.